Good morning, children.
So we discussed about the index numbers, isn't it? We discussed about types of index numbers, okay, and what are the factors, what are the limitations of index numbers, okay. We discussed about six types of index numbers: Fisher's index numbers, Faraday's index numbers, Lespierre's index numbers, Maxwell's index number, then relative price, simple, isn't it? So like that we learned eight types of, okay, construction of index numbers. This six formulas which we used, we call it as formula used for construction of index numbers. Okay, so today we are going to learn about test of adequacy of index numbers. So we learned that while writing limitations itself, we wrote, okay, there are so many methods for constructing index numbers. Which one is correct? We don't know, isn't it? So there is a test. Okay, using a particular test, you can check whether this index number, the construction of index number, is adequate or not. Is it correct? Is it valid? Okay, so that we can check it by using the testing. So write the heading: test of adequacy of index numbers. Test of adequacy of index numbers. So we have to select the appropriate method. After selecting a method, we can check whether that is appropriate for that. Is it correct? Is it adequate? We can check it. Okay, so write down: test of adequacy of index numbers. There are many methods to construct index numbers. Okay, just you note it down. So there are many methods to construct index numbers. Okay, write down this teaching note so that you'll be able to go through it. There are many methods to construct the index numbers. So the important thing is you have to select the appropriate method. So appropriate method. We have to select the appropriate method. So once we select a method, we can check: is it consistent? Is it good? Is it valid for that given data? We can check it. Check the consistency. We can check the consistency of a good index number. We can check the consistency. So there are four tests available, children. Listen all of you here afterwards. Okay. Listen, one second, afterwards you can write. There are four tests available for this. For checking the adequacy of index numbers, there are four tests available. For checking, there are four tests available. Okay, the first one is unit test. First one, unit test. Second one is time reversal test. Time reversal test. Third one is factor reversal test. Factor reversal test. And the fourth one is circular test. There are four tests available for testing the consistency of index numbers. There are four tests available, but this year we are going to learn only these two: unit test and time reversal test. Okay, there are four tests available for checking the consistency of index numbers. Okay, although there are four tests, we are going to consider only these two tests: unit test and time reversal test. We are going to learn about only these two tests: unit test and time reversal test. So what the unit test says is, listen, okay, first you write down all the four types. First write the four types. Okay, there are four types of testing. What are the four types of testing? Unit testing, time reversal test, factor reversal test, and circular test. Okay, so in unit test, what the unit test says is, while we are constructing the index number, if it is a good formula, if it is a good method for constructing the index number, it will be independent of the units. Okay, a good construction of index number, fair construction of index number formula is independent. It is independent of the units. For example, suppose we take the, suppose we compare the price values, okay, for 2 years. Suppose 1 year is 2010, the other one is 1990. When we compare it, few quantities will be in kg, few of them will be in liters. Okay, so it is in, it should be independent of the unit. Okay, so if it is a fair construction, if the construction of index number is good, means it will be independent of the units. Okay, and this method is applicable for this this test. You can apply it for all the test, and all the test will be satisfying, except the only one simple aggregative method will not satisfy this. Simple aggregative method will not be satisfying this unit test. Okay, the rest and all will satisfy. Okay, only this much we are learning about it. Unit test, what the unit test says, if the construction is done fairly, means it will be independent of all the units. Okay, and all the form, all the methods, that is, we have learned so many method, weighted method, unweighted method. Okay, all the methods will satisfy this unit test, except only one, which is the only one, simple aggregative method will not satisfy. All the methods except simple aggregative methods will not satisfy. Okay, so write down the heading, unit test. We learn only up to this, children, how to find out and all, we are not learning. Only this concept only we learn about unit test. Okay, so those who have the textbook, open your textbook. I think you can underline in the textbook itself. Take the page number 442. Take your textbook, page number 442. It is given there, unit test. What is unit test? The unit test states that, Aishwarya, read that one. Page number 442. Aishwarya is there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Unit test. This test states that the formula for constructing an index number should be independent of the units in which prices and quantities are expressed. All methods except simple aggregative method satisfy this test.
Okay, underline that one. So, which methods are not satisfying? Like that, MCQ will be asked. Unit test is not satisfied by which of the method? So, I'll underline that point. Okay, it is simple aggregative method. The next method we are going to learn is time reversal method. So, time reversal method. What is meant by time reversal? While calculating index number, we have some base year and we have some current year, isn't it? We calculate the index number for the current year based on the base year. Suppose we change these two, suppose we reverse these two, suppose we reverse it, then that, okay, if you reverse it, these two will be reciprocals of each other. These two will be the reciprocals, and when you take the product, you should get one. If it is satisfying, then we say it is, that test satisfies time reversal test. Time reversal test. Okay, is it clear, children? Suppose we, okay, suppose we reverse the years, base year and current year, suppose we reverse it, and if the index number, when we calculate the index number, if the index number is the reciprocal of the other one, okay, one index number is reciprocal of the other one, then it will be satisfying the time reversal test. Anila Mohanan, read that one, time reversal test.
Time reversal test is a test to determine whether a given method works both ways, forward and backward, in respect of time.
Underline that one. Underline. Okay. So, it works whether forward and backward. That means, you will be able to calculate it for the current year, as at the same time, you will be able to calculate it for the base year by changing the years. Okay. Then, read the next point, Anila.
This means, if the index number of the current year is computed on the basis of the base year, P01, and again, the index number of the base year is computed on the basis of the current year, P10. Then both the index numbers should be reciprocal of each other.
That underline, is underline all those things. Okay, so P01 is equal to 1 by P10. So that is P01 into P10 is equal to 1. When we take these two, that means we change the current year and base year. Okay, and when we change the current year and base year, the product must be 1. If the product is 1, then the given index number, that's the construction, satisfies the time reversal test. Okay, in other words, no matter which of the 2 years is taken as base, the product of the index numbers will be 1. Okay, it is okay. That means here in this test, we base year and current year we are exchanging. That means what is given? It is independent of the year. If you take the product of this index numbers, then it will be 1. Now look at here, children. Look at the next point. Time reversal test is satisfied by simple aggregative method and Fisher's method. These two methods satisfy time reversal. This test is not satisfied by Laspeyres and Pache's index number. It is not satisfied by Laspeyres and Pache's index number. Okay. So now let's do one problem now. Let's calculate. Okay, only one question is given in your textbook, that is the example 11. Example 11 is that question. Okay. And I have one extra question. For that one also we can check it. Okay, write the question. Write this question. Extra question, we are going to do it now. Write the question. Calculate Fisher's price index number. Calculate Fisher's price index number for the given data. Calculate Fisher's price index number for the given data and verify that it satisfies the time reversal test. Calculate Fisher's price index number for the given data and verify that it satisfies the time reversal test. So draw the table. Draw the table. Commodity. Price. Quantity. Commodity, price, quantity. It is again divided. Here it is 2008 in quantity, 2012. First one is rice, 10, 13, 4, 6, wheat, 15, 18, 7, 8. Then rent, 25, 29, 5, 9. Fuel, 11, 14, 8, 10. 11, 14, 8, 10. Look at the question. What is asked in the question? Calculate the Fisher's price index number. Calculate the Fisher's price index number for the following data. And you have to check whether it satisfies the time reversal test. Okay, time reversal test. So listen, what the time reversal test says that if we change, okay, we find P01 and P10. What is P01? P01 means, what is P01? Index number for the current year. Okay, current year only we denote it as 1 with the base year 0. Okay, P0 means price of the base year. P1 means price of the current year. Okay, so P01, Fisher's index formula is given like this. P01 is equal to, what is the formula? By the Fisher's index formula is P01 is equal to, what is the formula? P01 is equal to root of, it is root of sigma P1 q naught by sigma p naught q naught into sigma p1 q1 by sigma p naught q naught into 100. Okay, this is the formula for p naught 1. Is it clear, children? Look at here. P1 is the price for the year which one we want to set the index number. P0 is the price of the base year. Similarly, here it is Q0, Q1. Q0, Q1. So, we have to draw the columns P1, Q0. So, we want the column P1, Q0, then P1, Q1. Then we have to find out P0, Q0. P naught Q naught, find out. Then you have to find the sum. You have to find the sum also here. Root of, okay. P naught stands for the price of the base year. Q1 stands for the price of the current year. Q naught, quantity in base year, and Q1 quantity is consumed in the current year. Find out what is P1, Q0, P1, Q1. See, if you learn the formula only, you will be able to do index number. It is not at all a tough one. It is an easy one only.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Isn't it sigma P1, Q1 by sigma P0, Q1?
Sigma, which one? P1, Q0.
P1, Q1. The second one.
P1, Q1 by? Yes, yes, it is P0, Q1. Yes, it is P0, Q1. Yes. Only this years we change. Q1 will be same. Only P1 and P0 we change. Okay? P1, Q1. P0, Q0. P0, Q1. One more column we need, isn't it? P0, Q1. Calculate it and find the sum. Okay, do it. Okay, children, what is the answer? What we got as P1, Q0, Karthik? What is sigma P1, Q0?
Ma'am, whole sigma.
Sigma P1, Q0, final value.
Ma'am, 435.
435. Children, I am writing only the final value, okay? What about P1, Q1? Tomlin, P1, Q1.
Ma'am, 1 minute, I'm doing.
Okay. Over. Tomlin, what is P1, Q1?
Ma'am,
623. 623. Others, please check it, children. Is it correct? Then P naught, Q naught, Anila Mohanan, P naught, Q naught.
358.
P naught, Q naught is 358. Is it correct, Karthik?
Yes, ma'am.
Then P naught, Q1. And what about P naught, Q1, Aparna?
Ma'am, is it 515?
515. Is it correct, children, others? Is it, please check it. Is it correct? Yes, isn't it? Now simplify. Substitute the values. It is root of sigma P1, Q0. P1, Q0 is 435 by P naught, Q0. What is P naught, Q0? 358 into sigma P1 Q1 623 by P0 Q1 515 into 100. Now simplify this and find the square root. Simplify this and find the square root. So what is the answer, children? What is the final answer when you calculate? So what is the answer? What is the value? Final value, simplifying. Aishwarya?
One second, little more is that one.
Ah, okay. Here you can cut short it, isn't it? Simplify.
Then is it 120?
121.8 something. 121 point something. Is it? Check it. 121. Around 121. Are you getting? After decimal, some place 121 point something. Is it? Check. Are you getting like this? Around 121. Is it okay, Aditya? Karthik, finished? Is it okay? Up to one part only we have completed till now. What is the part we did? We calculated the Fisher's index number. Now what you have to do? We have to check whether it is satisfying the time reversal test. We have to check whether it satisfies time reversal test. Okay. So what you have to check? Well, that means what you have to find? So this is P01. Same way we have to find P10. Okay, when we find the product, we have to check whether you will get 1 or not. Okay, so that means to check the validity or to check whether the time reversal test is true means what you have to do? We have to find P01 into P10. When you take this product, you should get 1. So what is P01? Look at your children, P01. How will you calculate P01? So the first formula is same, sigma P1 Q0 into sigma P1 Q1 by sigma P0 Q0 into sigma P0 Q1 into P10. What is meant by P10? We take in the place of 0, you take it as 1, and in the place of 1, you put 0. Okay? Is it clear, children? P1 naught means you just exchange the suffix. But it is root of sigma P naught Q1 by sigma P1 Q1 into sigma P naught Q0 by sigma P1 Q0. Is it okay? What we did here, P10 means you just exchange the suffix. In the place of 0, you put 1. In the place of 1, you put 0. That's all. Okay. Now, look at the next one. This is same as root of. What we know? We know that root A into root B is, we can write it as a single root, which is root AB. So, we can write this as sigma P1 Q0 by sigma P0 Q0 into sigma P1 Q1 by sigma P0 Q1. Into sigma P0 Q1 by sigma P1 Q1 into sigma P0 Q0 by sigma P1 Q1 Q0. Now check what happens, whether everything will get cancelled. Sigma P0 Q0, here it is P0 Q0, P1 Q0, P1 Q1, everything will get cancelled. And are you getting this as 1? Is it same as 1? Everything will get cancelled. We are not at all substituting the value, but before substituting itself, we are getting 1. That means we can say Fisher's price index number satisfies time reversal test. Therefore, Fisher's price index number satisfies the time reversal test. Therefore, Fisher's price index number satisfies the time reversal test. Okay, P10, how we calculate P10? The formula P01, the Fisher's formula for P01, in the place of 1, we put 0, and in the place of 0, we put 1. Just you exchange the suffix. So, we get everything will get cancelled and we get that as 1. So, that means Fisher's index number satisfies time reversal test. Fisher's index number satisfies the time reversal test. Finished? Is it okay, Shubham, Tomlin? Yes, Tomlin. Finished it, Tomlin?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So with this our index number for the first term is over. Okay. Now we are going to start with the next topic, that is time series. Okay. Write the heading time series. Next heading is time series. Okay. Actually time. Okay. Time plays an important role in business history, isn't it? It plays an important role in economics, commerce, okay, commercial field and all. Time, it plays an important role. We know that as time changes, as years passes, we know that population is increasing or decreasing, cost is increasing, inflation is there, or some cost values are decreasing. Okay, so as time has an important role in economics, here we are going to learn about time series. Okay, so if you go to some offices and all, you can see some records were kept, not only in offices, almost all in all the business fields and all, what they will do, they will keeping the records sequentially arranged either it will be arranged chronologically, that is according to the date wise, it will be arranged. If you go through that recorded data, you can understand, from the recorded data you can understand there is some variation. In some period there is some increase, or during some particular time there is some decrease. If it is not for 1 year, if you can observe it, okay, so you can observe it for continuously 4 or 5 months. Okay, for example, you can okay, you might have seen in newspapers and all saying that whenever it is the time to school reopening, you can see that there is a seasonal increase in the selling of umbrellas, school bags, uniforms, is or no? So that happens every year during the month of which year? Okay, during the month of April, May, June, is or no? So like that it varies. Okay, therefore there is a trend. In this month, this is the trend. And we know when Onam season comes, we know that khadis and all, khadi silks and all, what they will have, they'll be have, there is a seasonal increase because of the season, because of this Onam season, everyone will buy handlooms and all. Is or no? So there is some season, okay, based on the previous year's records, we can analyze. And we can say, okay, this month, this will be the trend. Okay, if it is summer season, cotton sarees, cotton dresses will be more so. Is or no? Juices and ice creams will be more needed. So this is the trend. This month, this is the trend. Okay, you might have heard all those things. Okay, so the base, how we calculate this trend, based on this time analysis. Okay, one of you read the paragraph. Karthik, start reading time series. All of you take your text pencil. Time series.
Time series. There is a special significance of time in the economic and commercial world, because with time various kinds of changes can be seen in these fields, like increase in population, rise or fall in production, cost, etc. To check these changes, the basis of measures of time is 1 year, 1 month, 1 week, 1 day, 1 hour, 1 minute, etc. In simple words, the organized series of data on the basis of any measure of time is called time series.
Yes, underline that one, children. It is the organized data. Okay, it is organization of data. We are organizing it on the basis of either it will be for a year, 1 year we will observe and we will be giving, or for months, or it may be dates, or even it for times. Okay, look at the example given there. So that is for based on the year. Year wise, in 1961, what is the population? In 1971, what is the population? We are checking the population, we are calculating the population after every 10 years. So time series, it is used in statistics, pattern recognition, weather forecasting, earthquake prediction, astronomy, etc. In all these fields we use. Okay? Is it okay, children? It is used for this, just for model setting, a pattern setting. This is the pattern happened this year, so this will work out. Okay, but there is a chance it may fail. Okay, although we are saying this is the trend, suddenly the trend may change. So although we are setting it based on the previous records and all, the change may happen. Okay, so a time series is a sequentially recorded numerical data for a given variable arranged in a successive order to track the variation. What is the variation? To understand this variation, we use this data. Okay, what is meant by time series data? Is it okay? So there are three types. There are three types. Now down, time series. Okay, time series forecasting tools are used for information, are used on the information based on the history, based on the data collected, okay, based on the data collected in advance, okay, previous year's data and all, based on this only, we just predict the future pattern. We predict the future pattern, but we can't say it will be, it is, okay, we can't guarantee it. That's why I already said, it may change, suddenly it may change, okay. So we can't guarantee it. So there are such data analysis are of three types. First one is time series data. Time series data. Second one, cross-sectional data. Cross-sectional data. Third one is pooled data. Third one is pooled data. This is pooled data. Time series means, what will be time series? It is collected for different time years, different periods. For example, suppose we take population. Okay, we consider only one topic, population, and we look it for various years. Okay, but what about the next one? Cross-sectional data means we take one particular year. Period is fixed, but we look at for the different items. So in this year, what is the petrol value? What is the cost of current electricity rate? Everything. Is it clear? So period is fixed, but we take different items. What will be pooled data? Combination of these two. Combination of time series and cross section, we call it as pooled data. Children, we can discuss this one in the next period. Okay, one more period we have. That time we will be learning it in detail. Now for the time being, I stop it now. Okay, thank you.